Upscaling, resizing from a low to a high resolution. Without a doubt, it's always better to shoot at 4K, but if you're using a potato or trying to salvage the plates you've got, upscaling might be your only option. While there's a variety of tools and techniques to achieve this, often the results leave a lot to be desired. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to take a look at a new plugin for both After Effects and Premiere Pro called ScaleUp that takes upscaling to the next level. Just a note before we begin, this is not a sponsored video and I have no affiliation with the company. The commentary is based solely on my impressions of the software. Also, try to view the video in 4K if you can, otherwise a lot of the detail and the comparisons will be lost. Because of YouTube's additional processing, keep in mind that the overall result is probably a little softer than it was for me. To maximize detail in the plates while working in After Effects, I recorded this at 4K, so I apologize that the UI is pretty small. Maybe one day After Effects will get better scaling, but we're not quite there yet. And lastly, ScaleUp works with Premiere 2, the controls are the same, but After Effects is my software of choice. Alright, let's get started. For this demo, I took 4K stock footage and downsized it to 720. The goal is to see which method achieves the highest visual fidelity when compared with the original plate. First, the simplest approach is to scale the low-res plate 300% and change the quality and sampling switch from linear to bicubic filtering, which provides a nicer result than just using linear filtering. The image though is pretty soft and there's a clear lack of detail. Now let's take another copy of the plate, this time leave the scale at 100% and then apply a detail preserving upscale effect. Click the fit to comp width or height, or just increase the scale to 300%. And right away, you should see a lot more detail on the skin, around the eye, and the strands of hair. We can also increase the detail to 75%, and we see even more definition. And on this plate, there's no discernible artifacting. Now let's compare this effect to ScaleUp. On another copy of the plate, apply the effect. Like with the detail preserving upscale effect, we need to select the output size. I'll just choose fit to comp height. And without touching any of the other settings, we get a very blurry image. And this is because the denoise setting is too high. And I recommend that you set this to zero unless you specifically need to remove noise or artifacting. Then let's increase the sharpening. Setting this to 100 produces way too much detail, so let's decrease this back down to 15. Now we can see the individual strands of hair are clearer, there's slightly more texture on the skin, and there's a notable improvement to the model's eyes. Comparing this with the first scale plate with bicubic sampling, we see an even more noticeable improvement. So let's compare ScaleUp to the original 4K plate. Toggling between the upscale plate and the original, there's almost no discernible difference, especially when viewing at 100%. So for this plate, ScaleUp does a great job. Now let's compare render times. Here's a quick rundown on the settings that I used for the exports. These were rendered via the media encoder from a 16 bits per channel working space to H.265 with the 4K UHD preset. These were hardware encoded with an RTX 3090, and both the source and the output locations were on a single NVMe PCI 4 SSD, so the I/O latency should be pretty minimal. Use the results here simply as a baseline. Everyone's setup is different and your export settings are probably different too. Plus, each shot in this video is a different length and frame rate. Pay more attention to the render times relative to the various upscaled versions of the same shot. To minimize the loss of quality, the After Effects comps were imported directly into Premiere, so you're viewing the final export after the YouTube compression. The individual H.265 exports were just used for measuring the render times. So here, the 300% scale with bicubic sampling rendered the fastest, and the original 4K plate was next in line. Detail preserving upscale is notably slower, but it's to be expected since far more processing is now being done on the plate. ScaleUp further increases render time, but the result is by far the best of the upscale versions. If you'd like to try out ScaleUp for yourself, check the description for the link to the plugin page on aescripts.com. There's a fully functional trial version. It does have a watermark. However, this will allow you to check out the render times using your own hardware. Now let's look at this shot of a sea turtle, which is a more difficult shot to upscale. With a 300% scale and bicubic sampling, we get a pretty poor result. With the detail preserving upscale, by increasing the detail from 25 to 50 and upwards to 75 and 100, the definition seems sharper, but black borders appear around the pattern on the head. The shell looks a bit better, but we've also introduced more detail in the grain and the compression artifacting. I'm going to lower the detail to 75%, and to reduce the grain, I'll increase the reduced noise parameter to around 15. So now the background looks cleaner, but we lose detail on the turtle. Probably the best approach to alleviate the blurriness on the turtle would be to rotoscope it and then apply a separate detail preserving upscale on the background. But let's see how well ScaleUp handles it. Once again, we need to drop down the denoise, but in doing so, the background compression becomes more noticeable. So bump up the denoise back to around 15 or so. We're still losing detail in the turtle, but you should see a notable improvement on the head, neck, and shell when comparing ScaleUp to the detail preserving upscale. We can also add sharpening to bring out some of the details a bit more. One problem when dealing with upscaling footage with clear compression artifacts is that we have to apply denoise, but this also removes film grain. And it might seem counterintuitive to worry about removing grain, and so often we try to reduce it, but don't underestimate the importance of film grain. Almost any shot has some amount of natural grain, and you need to be mindful of how an up-res plate compares with other shots of the same sequence. In many cases, you may want to apply your own grain back over the denoise plate. Even simply using the add grain effect can alleviate this issue. Here I'll drop down the intensity to 0.1, the size to 0.75, and the shadows application to 0.75 as well, and this gives a much more natural looking result. There are probably better solutions, such as Magic Bullet's Renoiser, but this is the topic for another video, and I don't actually own that plugin. Lastly, when comparing the ScaleUp layer to the original 4K layer, we can see a loss of fine detail on the skin and the shell, but we can see the background still suffers from clear compression artifacting. The render times are a bit higher on this shot, but the difference between the detail preserving upscale and ScaleUp is minimal. This, however, is without the grain applied. Rendering with the grain drastically increases render time. I would like to see an update to ScaleUp that has a setting that can reintroduce grain, but as of this video, you have to do it manually with another effect. So let's take a look at this beautiful shot of an Italian church. Compare the bricks of the lower facade, bricks of the tower, and the tiles on the dome and the cross of the spire. There's a clear progression of clarity from left to right, and ScaleUp does a commendable job of restoring the image. Though there's a loss of quality on the statues and the background buildings when compared with the original 4K plate. ScaleUp is not perfect, but at 720, you lose so much detail. A much more reasonable use case would be upscaling from Full HD or 2K up to 4K. Those results are much better, but for the purposes of this demo, I really wanted to extenuate the differences between the various methods. And every shot is different. Some upscales are much more successful than others due to the resolution, compression, the objects in the scene, the camera motion, and so many other factors. So grab a trial version and see how well it works for the shots that you need to upscale. For the last comparison, I wanted to show how well ScaleUp handles text. The main reason I purchased this plugin was for upscaling a tutorial I made from 2K to 4K. Scaling up UIs and text is pretty difficult, and as you can see, even the detail preserving upscale isn't good enough to be able to read the text. But ScaleUp provides a clear, albeit slightly wobbly text. But as I said previously, 720 is really pushing it when it comes to upscaling. You'll get much cleaner results from 1080 and up. All in all, I'm impressed with the plugin and I think it's worth the price. If you're interested in upscaling for After Effects and Premiere, or upscaling in general, stay tuned for the next video where we'll be taking a look at Topaz Labs' Video Enhance AI. The results are impressive. If you found this overview of ScaleUp useful, a like really helps out the channel and helps me make more videos. If you have any questions, post here or reach out on the Discord server. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Peace.